Hi, my name is Patrick Reagan. Welcome to the Operating Systems Windows Architecture, where we go in depth of Windows by looking at the architecture of Windows 10 and 11. In part one, the main software components are covered, including the Windows kernel, executive services, object manager, kernel and non-kernel drivers, and the hardware abstraction layer, or HAL. Part one finishes discussing the Hyper-V architecture, which can run in Windows 10, Windows 11, and Windows servers. As with most of my videos, there are questions at the end of the video. A processor and a computer running Windows has two different modes, kernel mode and user mode. The processor switches between the two modes depending on what type of code is running on the processor. Kernel mode runs in the processor ring 0, and that includes the core operating system components and kernel mode drivers. All code that runs in kernel mode shares a single virtual address space. Code, including the kernel mode drivers, running in kernel mode isn't isolated from other drivers in the operating system itself. If a kernel mode driver accidentally writes to the wrong virtual address, data that belongs to the operating system or another driver, the system could be compromised and the entire system could crash. Think blue screen of death or similar error. User mode runs in processor ring 3 and is used by applications and non-kernel drivers. When you start a user mode application, Windows creates a process for the application. Each application runs in isolation. The process provides the application with a private virtual address space and a private handle table. If the application crashes, the crash is limited to that one application. Because an application's virtual address space is private, one application can't alter data that belongs to another application. A process running in user mode can access virtual addresses that are reserved for the operating system or kernel mode. Kernel mode has complete access to hardware and computer system resources. It executes the code in a protected memory area. It consists of the Windows microkernel, the executive services, kernel mode drivers, in the hardware abstraction layer, or HAL. Hardware abstraction layer, or HAL, allows the computer OS to interact with the hardware device without knowing how every hardware device works. Hardware abstractions often allow programmers to write device-independent, high-performance applications by providing standard operating system, or OS, calls to the hardware. HAL is responsible for controlling I/O interfaces, interrupt controllers, and various processors. The kernel is a computer program at the core of the computer's operating system and generally has complete control over everything in the system. The kernel is the first program to load after the bootloader. After loading, it controls and coordinates every other program and process. The Windows kernel, sometimes referred to as microkernel, is the hybrid kernel which combines features and benefits of a microkernel and monolithic kernel architectures. Monolithic kernels are generally faster and more efficient than microkernels. Microkernels provide stability because they're more modular than monolithic kernels, which has services separated into its different processes. Microkernels make it easier to add or remove services without affecting other parts of the system. The Windows microkernel is responsible for multiprocessor synchronization, thread scheduling, interrupt and exception dispatching, trap handling, initializing device drivers, and interfacing with the process manager. ntoskrnl.exe, short for the Windows NT Operating System Kernel Executable, also known as the kernel image, contains the kernel and executive layers of the Microsoft Windows kernel. Executive services provide process structure, memory and object management, process and thread scheduling, input and output management, interrupt processing, security, and other key operating system functions. The Windows executive services make up the low-level kernel mode portion and are contained in the file ntoskrnl.exe. Resources, which are treated as logical objects, each reside in a namespace for categorization. Resources can be physical devices, files or folders on volumes, registry entries, or even running processes. Object Manager manages Windows resources. All other executive subsystems and system calls must go through the Object Manager to access objects. I/O Manager allows devices to communicate with user mode subsystems, including allowing communication between applications and the interfaces provided by device drivers. Virtual Memory Manager controls how applications manage virtual memory in Windows, allowing applications to execute and manage their own address space without the need to consider the impact on other processes in the system. Because of the Virtual Memory Manager, applications are able to reserve, commit, free, change, lock, and query the virtual memory they require. IPC is short for Inter-Process Communications. The IPC manager is a mechanism provided by an operating system for processes to manage shared data, including sharing communications and data between applications, such as Microsoft Office applications, typically in a client requesting or server provider role. The Security Reference Monitor manages security between objects and action requests. It provides routines to drivers, and Security Reference Monitor allows system devices to access the Windows Access Control List, which determines which objects have what security. Plug and Play Manager, or PMP Manager, is a combination of hardware technology and software techniques that enable a PC to recognize when a device is added to the system. It is responsible for controlling or managing the addition of I/O devices to the system without requiring interaction from the user, or if the setup requires interaction, with minimum input on the part of the user. Power Manager manages the change in power state for all devices supporting such change, such as external monitors. Windows Manager is a software that controls the placement and appearance of Windows within the Windows system in a graphical user interface. Direct3D replaces Direct2D in Graphics Device Interface, or GDI. The Win32k.sys driver is the kernel side of some core parts of the Windows subsystem. It provides GUI for Windows and is responsible for Windows management. As mentioned earlier, User Mode is in the processor ring 3. The integral subsystem allows Windows to run applications that are written for different operating systems. Original environment subsystems including Win32, OS2, and POSIX. Linux replaced POSIX, and Android support was added to Windows 11. Environment subsystems perform essential system functions. Security creates security tokens that are used with rights and permissions, determine what needs to be audited, and accepts user login requests and initiates authentication. Workstation service allows Windows to access network resources, including shared folders and printers, using the Server Message Block or SMB protocol. Server service provides network resources such as shared folders and printers. While you may associate Hyper-V virtualization with Microsoft Windows servers, Hyper-V can run on Windows 10 and 11. Hyper-V is Microsoft's hardware virtualization product that can run a software version of a computer called a virtual machine. The hypervisor is core to virtualization. It is the processor-specific virtualization platform that allows multiple isolated operating systems to share a single hardware platform. Hyper-V supports isolation in terms of a partition. A partition is a logical unit of isolation supported by the hypervisor in which the operating system executes. The Microsoft hypervisor must have at least one parent or root partition running Windows. The virtualization management stack runs in the parent partition and has direct access to hardware devices. The root partition then creates the child partitions, which host the guest operating systems using the HyperCall Application Programming Interface, or API. The root partition is responsible for providing the device drivers for the virtual machines running the child partitions, managing the child partitions lifecycles, power management, and event logging. The root partition operating system also hosts the virtualization stack, which is responsible for performing a wide range of virtualization functions. VM Bus is part of the Hyper-V integration services that facilitates higher optimized communications between child partitions and the parent partition. Partitions do not have access to physical processor, nor do they handle the processor interrupts. Instead, they have a virtual view of the processor and run a virtual memory address region that is private to each guest partition. The hypervisor handles the interrupts to the processor and redirects them to the respective partition. Requests to the virtual devices are redirected either via the VM bus or the hypervisor to the devices in the parent partition, which handles the requests. Question: what is the most secure mode in Windows that executes the code in protected memory area where the Windows microkernel and executive services runs in? Answer: kernel mode. Question: where does the applications and non-kernel drivers run in? Answer: user mode. Question: what allows Windows to interact with the hardware device without knowing how every hardware device works? Answer: Hardware Abstraction Layer. Question: what is the kernel that Microsoft Windows uses? Answer: microkernel. Question: in Windows, what is the name of the Windows operating system kernel executable? Answer: ntoskrnl.exe. Question: what do you call the combination of hardware and software techniques that enables a PC to recognize when a device is added to the system? Answer: Plug and Play Manager. For more information, visit these sites. In summary, a processor in a computer running Windows has two different modes: user mode and kernel mode. User mode, processor ring 3, is used by applications and non-kernel drivers. Kernel mode, processor ring 0, includes core operating system components and kernel mode drivers. Kernel mode has complete access to hardware and computer system resources. Hardware abstraction layer, or HAL, allows a computer OS to interact with hardware device without knowing how every hardware device works. The kernel is a computer program at the core of the computer operating system and generally has complete control over everything in the system. The Windows kernel, sometimes referred to as the microkernel, is a hybrid kernel which combines features and benefits of microkernel and monolithic kernel architectures. HyperV supports isolation in terms of a partition. Thank you for watching this video. The next video will be operating systems, Windows architecture, part 2. Thank you.